very interesting. It's true that I seem to have a different approach than others. But I find this approach very, very interesting. I enjoy it. It seems to be full of tremendous hope for success. And so, we're going to continue on with the hope of success in these days where there is the potential for so much chaos in the world, actually. The remedy, what we're looking for, actually, is pure happiness. And we need to not hear this intellectually or to figure anything out. Spirit to spirit, and this is there is pure happiness. There is pure happiness. I've experienced it. I'm aware that it's like, it's our true being. It's pure happiness, uncaused by anything. Uncaused by anything. It is our natural state, not caused by any situation or thing whatsoever. Completely independent of anything that happens. Now, why do we have such trouble with this? I'm going to try to explain this. It's very important. We are literally trying to organize chaos here. And so we want to be able to define everything in terms of causation, actually. Chaos, you cannot define causation. Why are we trying to do this? We try to be separate from God, greater than God, which gave rise to this experience of reality as pure, endless chaos, actually. The attempt to define reality as something other gives rise to this experiencing of absolute chaos. This is something I've covered in quite a bit. So for the time being, let's just say, okay, let's just take that as a given. Then the universe is our attempt to organize chaos, to try and work on symbolically organizing it. And we're obsessed with cause and effect, trying to determine, well, what caused this, and what caused that, and what caused that, like, to try and structure chaos, trying to figure a way to structure chaos so we can be happy with it, so we can feel that we're God, greater than God, and we're all happy with this experiencing of being greater than God. Now, what happens when we have an experience, we're experiencing pure happiness, and we can't find any cause for it? We get very nervous about that, actually. We get very nervous about that. There, that's why we avoid pure happiness. We say, I can't find the cause for it. And that brings up the thread of endless chaos for us, endless chaos. We can't find a cause for reality, can we? Can we find a cause for pure freedom? Is pure freedom caused? No, pure freedom is. Reality is causeless, actually. It's causeless. But when we want it to be the cause of reality, greater than God, we want it to say that we caused reality. That's this endless chaotic chaos arose as an experiencing for us. We're trying to structure it, figure it out in the universe here, organize everything. But pure happiness has no cause. There's nothing to order, there's nothing to structure. And this is just like, we can't seem to accept this. We cannot. And so you don't see this pure happiness in the world. You really don't see it, do you? Best example of pure happiness I've seen in this world that I've seen is Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, for sure. Pure happiness, no question about it. Uncaused pure happiness. This is something we're not used to experiencing here. And we try to figure out, well, what's causing this? We always say, what's causing this? And we say, well, it's uncaused. Meltdown. And yet we can practice this in our being, saying pure happy, uncaused, and just abide in what is uncaused. Try abidance in what is uncaused. You will find a great deal of fear shaking and trembling through you. You're terrified of not being able to find causation, because the absolute endless, the endless chaos that arose when we tried to say that we're greater than God, separate from God, causing God, was so terrifying that we have been frantically trying to work on the structuring and causation to protect against this. So any thought of like, this is has no causation to it, oh man, you know, so we're super defended against that, super defended against it. This happiness is uncaused. Since it's not caused by anything, there's nothing that can cause it to be something other than that either. Nothing can damage it, touch it, change it, do anything. It's not caused. It has no cause. It just is. And of course, our mind is obsessed with causation. So it seems like our mind is just has a very difficult time with this. And we try to say, well, what are you going to do? You know, and try to establish causation by what, you know, what pure happiness does. Pure happiness just is happy. It doesn't need to do anything to be happy. Now, I've seen the remedy for these times that we live in is pure happiness. There's no question about it. That is what we actually need. We need to get away from causation, this obsession with causation, cause and effect. And see, isn't there something that is free of cause and effect? We're just so tired, and say, yes, pure happiness is free of cause and effect. And our minds simply are incapable, seemingly incapable of. Certainly they can't understand it. There's nothing to understand. But accepting it is very difficult. But we have to do this. We have to do this. We need to do it. We need to accept pure happiness, really. The pure happiness that is, was, quote unquote, within, that was Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, for example, to use the best example I know of, it's exactly the same as what's in every single one of us. Exactly the same. No difference. And that happiness, we can be aware of that, actually. No difference between us and Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, or, you know, or anyone else that allowed was this pure happiness to be present and expressed and felt in this world. No difference. It's the same. The result of this is people forget the conflicts. They forget conflict. Now, people don't want to forget conflict because they're problem solving. They're trying to solve the problems of chaos, endless chaos. So they feel they need to really be working on that. Of course, we can simply drop this ridiculous whim of trying to be other than God, greater, separate, other than God, and then there is no endless chaos to deal with whatsoever. And we don't need to be problem solving. We don't need to call to mind, okay, well, what is it that's disturbing our peace, our happiness? Our happiness is not being disturbed. We're presuming that it's been disturbed, or will be disturbed. We're presuming that it's a product, that this pure happiness is a product of all the work we've done in this universe to structure endless chaos. It is not. It is not a product of anything that we have done. It's not a product of effort at all. Which then gives the lie to all this activity and effort in the world, doesn't it? Which is why in the presence of pure happiness, you're not in like a problem-solving mode. You say, what problems? I don't need to fix any problems. Pure happiness is here with me now. It's completely independent of this universe. The universe has no effect on it. So, and what do I need the universe for then, right? Well, of course we think, well, of course we need the universe. No, we don't. We don't need the universe at all. So it's pure happiness or the universe. You have to choose one or the other. Can't have both. Now, first time I saw Sri Sri onto my mind, I said, boom, that's what I really want, instantly. What was I talking about? Pure happiness. That's the quality. I felt the quality instantly. I said, that's what I really want, for sure. That's what we all really want, actually. But we keep thinking we need to solve the problems of the universe to get it. That is not true. We don't need to do anything to get it. It's already here. It's already perfect. The universe has nothing to do with what we are, actually. It's an attempt to solve a non-existent problem, actually, the universe. Chaos, endless chaos, is not a problem, really. It's a reaction to a whim of a desire. But the desire is impossible to experience. So, all we have to do is drop the desire and that's the end of it. But our continuity fear doesn't really allow us to do that. However, we're working on it now, and we're really looking at this. When pure happiness is present, all of the conflict, everything we're doing in the universe just is silly. It's just, why? We don't need to resolve anything. We don't need to fix anything. We just say, we don't even know, what were we even, I don't know, there's no problem at all. Nobody feels any problem anymore. Nobody feels the need to attack, do anything to try and, you know, change something in the universe. You just say, oh, it doesn't matter. This universe doesn't matter. Nothing that happens here matters at all. So why are we fighting over something? It's ridiculous. Let's just be happy. Let's just be happy. Now, we're all trained that this universe is super purposeful. Well, it is, but the purpose is not needed. Because all we have to do is repent, and there's no endless chaos to deal with, to try and structure. And reality's never had any endless chaos. Pure happiness has never been in endless chaos at all. It can never be. It can never be. Absolutely can never be. So the emergence of this pure happiness is really what we're aiming for. this isn't just some blank state of I'm just the total awareness, and it's just kind of silent state. It is literally this radiant in all directions, so to speak, just tremendous happiness, bliss. Just the super positivity, just this without any need for any thought at all. Without any causation whatsoever. You can call it pure love if you want to. Pure freedom, pure joy, pure bliss. Without any causation. Just radiating. You know, you just can't believe the people who went to see Sri Sri Anandamayi. I've talked to some of them. You just can't believe it, you know. It's just, there are no words, you know, to feel this pure happiness. It's just, you can't even it's like the universe ends. You're no longer in the universe. The universe doesn't matter. You don't need the universe. You don't need anything. Pure happiness doesn't need anything. It's the need-free state, totally need-free. It doesn't need anything to be what it is. It doesn't need to feed on something, you know. No, it's just this. It's radiating this. It's not in a deficit mode at all. It's not in any deficit mode. It's not an energy, really. It's not something that can ever experience a deficit. It's impossible. And of course, the model of a universe is a very, very misleading model for what we are, actually. Totally misleading. This world, this universe, is nature is completely misleading as to what we truly are. It has nothing to do with what we observing this universe and how it works. Absolutely nothing to do with what we are. So the idea that we have to figure out, well, how did this universe give rise to this pure happiness? It didn't. The universe has nothing to do with giving rise to anything about reality. Reality doesn't need the universe. Reality does not need any universe whatsoever. So we don't need to answer, well, how did this arise from out of this universe? It didn't. What we need to answer is, how did the universe arise at all? Well, it's a reaction to, a panicked reaction to endless chaos, an attempt to structure it, attempt to defense mechanism, actually. And this endless chaos arose as a reaction to us trying to be other. That's what it arose from. And we can't be other or separate from God. So all we have to do is drop this crazy, stupid whimsical desire. There's no more reaction. There's no more defense against the reaction. So the idea of, well, how does the universe give rise to anything doesn't really matter. We don't have to answer that question. We just simply don't need the universe. We don't need anything that the universe can give us. We absolutely do not need anything that this universe can give us. It can't give us anything, actually. There's nothing that this universe can do to give us anything whatsoever, anything real whatsoever. We don't need anything. We already have everything that we are. And neither can the universe take away anything of what we are. It can't do anything to us. It's enough just to consider this and hear this. And just say, wow. You see, the problems that we're engaged in this world are resolved by simply saying we don't need them. We don't need to do anything about this universe whatsoever. Disinterest. You say, I'm not interested. I don't need the universe. So you're not going to keep on dreaming. It's kind of like somebody who's dreaming this terrible conflict, and then they realize, I don't need to dream. I don't need to dream. Do they need to resolve all the conflicts in the dream at all? No, they don't need to do anything. They just say, oh, I don't need to dream. And all dreams go with that realization. I don't need to dream. The universe is just a dream. I don't need to dream. We're the ones dreaming the dream. We don't need to dream. So it doesn't matter what's taking place in the universe at all. We simply don't need the universe at all. Pure happiness is not a product of anything whatsoever. It was not produced by the universe. It's not sustained by the universe. The universe plays no role in it whatsoever. There's no question we have to decondition ourselves from our false teachings that we are, so many for so long. But we can do it. We just look at it and say, oh, I could see the chain of what's going on. I can see it. Say, wow. So when people realize, they feel, hey, you know what? I don't really need the universe. Are they going to spend time fighting with somebody or conflict? They just say, hey. Isn't this great news? Wow. And they just accept the good news, and it is, peaceful. There's nothing has to happen, nothing has to be done. I'm in pure happiness. And then this counters the contagion of the world of thinking we need to do something, tackle problems, tackle chaos. We're parsing out chaos a little bit at a time, sometimes a lot at a time, and then working, trying to structure it. What a very, very miserable activity, isn't it? Terrible. Thinking that we need to do this in order to be happy. In order to be happy, we think we have to make this universe perfect in order to be happy. Could you imagine that? And the fact is, we have pure happiness right now. Don't have to do anything whatsoever for this to be so. So invite this happiness into your awareness. Invite the happiness into your being. It's there. It is there for sure. I experienced it just a little while ago. Some people call it the divine child, the divine child within us, the unborn divinity within us. But it's there, and you can experience it. I experienced it, and it's just like, wow, just pure. pure, 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 radiant bliss. Not bliss over anything. It's not saying I'm so blissful over what's happening in this universe. It's just pure bliss, not related to any happening whatsoever. And the bliss is capable of expressing and overflowing, yes. But we don't need to try to intellectualize. Let's not go too deep into that. It's not important. Because the ego gains a toehold there. You know, the ego wants to... The ego cannot deal with this information, actually. There's nothing for the ego to do. So the ego says, well, what's my role in all this? There isn't any role. Well, the ego says, well, how do I keep it going? How do I, like as a machine, how do I, you know, the ego thinks everything's a machine. It has to, how do I, you know, keep the programming, make sure the programming doesn't go ahead. No, there's no programming involved. See, this is the problem with the programmers. They always think there's programming involved in everything. There's no programming involved in reality whatsoever. There's nothing that can go wrong. There's nothing that needs to be deprogrammed. But our continuity fear is something that we need to go through this ordeal of like, wow, this is different than what I've been telling myself. All right, now let's see if I can get this video up on YouTube. Having problems again of not processing my these videos. So this is certainly, you know, worth putting up there and making available to the world, because it contains considerations that are extraordinarily unusual to consider, but vitally important as we go forward in this time frame we're in right now, and this is through the events and, you know, what people are talking about right now. You know, even if nothing happens in this world as far as events, the level of fear and paranoia in the thinking of what could potentially happen is in itself a happening. Do you get that? It is in itself a happening. This is how what this world has been whipped into a frenzy. It is itself a happening. Now, I've pointed out in the past that this is going to take place, this climate of extreme emotionalism, and people might say, well, you help contribute to it. Well, not really, because I'm pointing out the remedy, and people are saying, well, might say, well, what do we need this remedy for? You know, the things aren't going to be so bad. I need to say, yes, they will be very bad. Even if nothing happens so bad, the climate of fear and paranoia and just doom, you know, is just like palpable in the world. That itself is doom. That itself is doom. So I've been pointing out that we're going to go into this doom mindset one way or the other. And the only way to really counter that is through pure happiness. It's the only way to really counter it. Again, the doom mindset itself is doom. The distrust of government, the distrust of people, rightly so. The conspiracy theories, rightly so, because there are many conspiracies. There, all of this is fermenting, and in itself is like, it's like the world just covered with this deep, dense, dark cloud of fear. Okay? That itself is an incredible catastrophe and disaster for us. And it's not getting any better because of all the technology, all the possibilities of things going wrong, and things have gone wrong, and you know, just so much. There's just overall climate of fear, and that is in itself doom. That is a horrible catastrophe, and we're already in that, and it's not getting any better. So the remedy is to play the trump card is pure happiness, which this universe has absolutely nothing, no causation. It's not causing it in the slightest bit. Never has and never will. So nothing that takes place here in this world has the slightest effect on pure happiness. That sort of, you know, dispels the doom, doesn't it? Just, there's no doom for pure happiness. Pure happiness. You see, ordinarily, what we call ordinary happiness, there's plenty of doom for that. We're experiencing it right now. That's the universal happiness, happiness from the universe. But pure happiness, there's no doom for pure happiness. It's ever radiant and overflowing. And anamayi means overflowing bliss. It's always overflowing. There's no end to it. It's not an energy. It's uncaused. It's always extending more and more. We cannot understand it in terms of the universe at all. So, this is the necessary remedy. It is the necessary remedy. And the whole mood of doom can be dispelled this way. Because it doesn't matter what happens. It doesn't matter if the whole universe, actually the entire universe is a conspiracy. The entire universe from its very inception is a conspiracy. It's a conspiracy to overthrow God, actually. And trying to organize endless chaos and certain find out ways to structure and organize so then we can feel happy about being greater than God. It's an attempt to overthrow God, the entire universe is. So it's better to look at it that way than to this all these various small little bits of doom. Think about big doom. The whole universe is a conspiracy. Enslaving. The whole universe is an enslavement. We're enslaving ourselves, trying to enslave ourselves, enslaving our attention to trying to structure and organize form and energy. The whole universe is an enslavement conspiracy. From its very beginning, that's what it is. So look at it that way instead of all these little picky stuff. No, look at the big doom, not the little doom, the big doom. And then when you see that the big doom, what it really is, they say, well, I need to bring the pure happiness in to deal with this, don't I? That's the real remedy for this situation that we have. I realize that we just don't need it. We don't need it. Just like a dream. We could be dreaming of a whole universe, billions of years, with endless chaos and conflict and problems. And we could just realize, oh, I don't need to dream anymore. I don't need to dream. I don't need to dream. I have pure happiness. Pure happiness is not a product of a dream. It's not, I don't need to dream anymore. This is what I really want. Stop dreaming. All of the problems and conflicts that are the dream go vanish along with the dream. This is how it has to take place. This is the way. So take this to heart. Take it to heart. Take it to heart. Just listen to it. And just wow. Don't try to think about it. Just say, wow, big picture. Big picture. I like that. I like it. Put a like. I like the big picture. I like this big picture. Alright, let's see if I can get this video to process. I know that's uploading, but it's not processing. That's the issue. Okay, great, that's it.